Hey there, what's up everyone? This is Chris and you are in my space for project managers and for those who is willing to become one of these guys. And now the time has come to talk about the work breakdown structure. To make a quick recap, in the previous video we have been discussing project scope and also we have configured the project scope out of the project requirements. As a potential project requirements, we have taken a request from the client who wants to build a mobile application that would allow his customer to order from the restaurant. If you haven't seen this video, check it out here. So here it goes. In our list of deliverables, we have products with the opportunity of reading and reviews, ordering system with the functionality of booking calendar and personal data storage, and payment method with the possibility of choosing the payment options. And this is gonna be our scope of work for this project. So today we will use that scope of work that we have built in the previous video and we'll try to make a decomposition and to prepare the work breakdown structure. Also, we will discuss what next is gonna happen on the project. So if you haven't done this yet, subscribe now, tap the notification bell and let's move forward. So, we have analyzed the project requirements, we have configured the scope of work and potentially have put it into the project management tool. What's next? Now we have come to the WBS or work breakdown structure. So, work breakdown structure is a smaller component that we need to process in order to deliver the product functionality. And this is something that the team is working with and estimating it and reporting their progress against it. Returning to our sample of project scope, let's pick one of the features or deliverable out of there and to make a decomposition. So decomposition is a functionality breakdown and it is needed in order to clearly see what steps and activities we need to undertake in order to deliver this feature. So out of those items from the sample scope of work, I would want to go, for instance, let's say with products. And based on the requirements, we can assume that every product should have image, description, price, rating and review functionality. So to do this, first of all, we need to create the database where all this information is going to be stored to be reflected on the application screen. Further on, most likely there will be many products and therefore we need a page with a list of all products to allow clients to look them through and to pick the ones that they're mostly interested in. Next, as we need every product to have a description, price and so on and so forth, we need another page which is gonna be an individual product page. And there we also gonna put our rating and reviews functionality. So for this item of the scope list, which is products, we gonna have this decomposition. So to deliver this functionality, we need to have a database, we need to have a list of product pages, we need to have an individual product page, we need to build the reviews functionality and the rating functionality. Okay, so now we have a work breakdown structure. And next important document that we would want to build is project specification. So project spec is a document that contains the description of the solution workflow. And usually this is a collaborative work with the project technical lead and a designer. This is extremely important because this document would help to eliminate possible misunderstanding, miscommunication of the final product that we are going to deliver within this project. And during the project, all the team and the client and stakeholders would have a possibility to refer to this document and to refresh the information about the functionality that was agreed in the very beginning of the project. So guys, today we have discussed the very important part of the project planning process. We have built the project scope, created the work breakdown structure and put an eye on the project specification. So time to meet the project team. And this is what we are going to discuss in the next meeting. So tap the notification bell if you haven't done this yet and see you next week.